So here's a series that Arthur wanted me to go over before. It's an anime manga series called Beastars, and as I mentioned, it's like a Japanese Zootopia. Popularity for furry media comes and goes. People talk about this and that until it dies down, and then another set comes out that gets people talking about it again. Beastars is part of that cycle, even though there are some things keeping it from being as amazing as some may want it to be. But let's start from the beginning. Beastars was the creation of Paru Itagaki, who debuted in 2016 with this and another manga called Beast Complex. She's also the daughter of Kisuke Itagaki, another Japanese manga artist behind Baki the Grappler, that martial arts series that's even more insane with its muscular characters than JoJo. I mean, if you really want to know how insane, just hit YouTube and look at any of the fights they have, especially for the 2018 anime. Both Beastars and Beast Complex were published in Weekly Shonen Champion, and both manga deal with similar themes of coexistence and interspecies romance, though Beast Complex was more like a complementary series to what would become Beastars, since it had stories on different character couples. Beastars, by contrast, is primarily centered around a central cast of characters. Now, the manga series is currently ongoing, while the anime is only in its first season. Well, I'll try to draw comparisons to the former based on what I could safely find. Now, from the cover art of the original manga, or at least the proto-Beast Complex from 2013, you would think this series, that would later inspire it, would have its share of wholesome elements mixed in with sexual activity, which is fine. But right away, the series opens with a murder. Well, that's one way to start things off, but compared to what I found in the manga, the anime goes for more atmosphere and effect when playing out these dramatic scenes. In fact, to get the animation out of the way, it's interesting seeing how Paru's designs translate into CG animation done by Orange Co., which did Land of the Lustrous and some Star Fox Zero animation. While some of the funniest expressions you could ask for in a manga are not here, you do get plenty of color and consistent design work in the cast and environment. Of course, something else that the anime does that unfortunately kinda dampens the experience a bit, a lot of the manga's stories and plot points get condensed. The Beastars wiki goes on and on about the differences between both mediums, but in any case, we get an introduction to one major character, Legoshi. I hear it as Legosi, so I'll just stick with that. He's a shy, awkward wolf who only looks imposing because of his size and carnivore nature. A scene from a school he attends shows some of the problems that come from being a meat eater, for while herbivores and carnivores get along there most of the time, every once in a while, the latter group gets easily accused of wrongdoing, which also leads to an issue some have regarding the topic of racism. But we'll get back to that later. In any case, Legoshi becomes a suspect in the murder case. Yet in reality, he was just a friend of the murder victim. We then get to the object of Tem's affections, Els. And when she thought she was going to die by Legoshi's hand, she spouted the same specious garbage Tem did before his death. In truth, he wanted to give her the love letter from Tem, and she ends up apologizing for it. Parts of the manga are still in the anime, thus leading to this exchange from Legoshi.
そうだけど、このままじゃ私、あなたに申し訳ないわ。今までと特に変わらないから大丈夫。怖がられても、嫌われても、そうやって生きてきた。
From just chapter 1 alone, we see Lugosi as someone who might have some hidden side to him. But he may just be a nice guy just trying to get by despite the world crapping on him. What doesn't help is the anime streamlining his character development and introducing other characters quickly. Because shortly after, we get our introduction to Lewis. He's the leader of the drama club that Lugosi is a part of. And a hard nut to crack. On the one hand, he's an arrogant, straight-A student who hides behind his accomplishments, when in reality, he's a bit fragile. Yet something about him just makes you pay attention, since he becomes Lugosi's friend and tormentor. I swear I'll get more into this series' animal culture, but let's get to Haru. She's a dwarf rabbit best known for her many sexual relations with various male classmates, thus making her a bit of an outcast. Not helped either by how blatant she is with admitting it. Of course, we later learn why she's like this, and how similar she is with Lewis regarding their mental stability, or lack thereof. But in any case, Lugosi's feral instincts awaken when he smells Haru for the first time, and the anime goes the extra mile by making the experience exhilarating. So. この世界で勝者になるのは、こうやって本能をむき出して引き出ちゃうやつよ。私はいつも敗者にすらなれない。私のことなんかもうくれてあげる。ただこのしょうもない人生でも逃げる意味とか怖くて泣きたいとかそういうのちゃんとあったってこと。
Now
all this encompasses the manga's first four chapters, which is quite brisk by adaptation standards. For context, animes try to reserve the first episode for the manga's first chapter, then compress about two or three chapters from that point forward. Worth repeating, Beastars is trying to pack four episodes into one episode. In fact, all of the episodes are like this. This decision changes the overall tone of the series. The manga, while obviously sporting the themes of racial tensions and interracial relationships, actually has its share of lighthearted moments. Characters have the space to be happy teenagers with various hobbies and stuff, and the manga gets to flesh them out as complex and messy individuals. The anime, on the other hand, is a bit bleaker. And with all the truncated character building from the manga, it chose to focus on the dramatic parts, especially the relationship between Lugosi and Haru. Speaking of, remember how Lugosi's instincts didn't perk up when acting around Els, but does around Haru? That can only be explained by one theory. He really likes her. Haru, for her part, responds well to Lugosi's empathetic demeanor, and she starts opening up to him as time goes on. We learn that her sleeping around is her only way of being taken seriously. Otherwise, she's treated as some helpless object who needs constant protection. This back and forth eventually leads to a relationship. Both characters do like being around each other, but they aren't sure if it's for real just yet. But let's take a step away from that and get back to Lewis. He keeps wondering why Lugosi hides his carnivore nature, and that question stems from his childhood experience with other meat eaters. He was once for sale in a black market, as meat for the carnivores. I promise, just a moment. But then he finds himself sold to another deer named Agma, head of the Horns conglomerate, this encounter spared Lewis from being lunched, and it undoubtedly led to his resolve against those wanting to eat him.
I am the president of the Ogma. I can't have a child. But I will live as a real son of your blood. I am the president of the Ogma. You can change this
world. Now, let's discuss the world of Beastars itself. Animals of all kinds exist in this world, and the variety gives the show a similar vibe to Zootopia. But unlike Zootopia, or even One Piece, where the animal characters have the capacity to be friendly, everyone in Beastars has the inbuilt ability to be dicks to one another. This applies especially to carnivores. When they are aggressive, they don't screw around. And whatever sort of evolutionary path they took, the Beastars animals still can't wholly leave behind their animal instincts hiding behind their civilized veneer. The government does forbid anyone from eating animal meat, but real meat is available on the black market. Hell, animals can offer themselves as a tasty meal, and eating it supposedly makes one stronger and more dangerous. Drinking animal blood is like the equivalent to taking drugs, as Bill the Tiger demonstrates to Lugosi. But the real divide between herbivores and carnivores comes to this one dynamic. The former group likely controls the bulk of government offices and responsibilities, so the carnivores have no choice but to appear approachable and safe for their plant-eating counterparts. But even with this adjustment, they are still understood as suspicious individuals because of their true animalistic nature. Remember how casually speciesist some herbivores were in the academy? The wider world of Beastars is like that times a million. But that leads to a problem that the anime has when it attempts to depict those tensions. Most of the carnivores in this series act exactly alike. Besides someone like Lugosi, they are overly aggressive, have hair-trigger tempers, and constantly threaten to eat each other. The characterization is so one-note that it gives the false impression that everyone is born either good or evil. There is one way for animals to change the world, and that is to achieve a certain title for standing out in society and uniting everyone despite their differences. That title is also the name of this series. So ultimately, it seems the series wants us to watch over these various kids to see if any of them can reach that title. But saying it right here, that's an impossible bar to achieve, and that this society decided to hold its members to that standard shows how effed it is. So we're left with something else the anime focuses on more compared to the manga. The romance. The stuff with Lugosi and Haru is both cute and funny. But Lugosi later finds himself in a love triangle, courtesy of Juno. She's another wolf who had to deal with the sort of suspicions that carnivores face, though she tends to take those problems in stride ever since meeting Lugosi. She too grows a crush on him due to his kind nature, and eventually sees the rabbit as a romantic rival.
私は女としてあなたに勝ってみせます。隕石祭でそれを証明しますから。
On Haru's side, there's still some residual sexual tension with Louis, who she slept with before. She also helped him while he was shedding his antlers a while back, and even though they're just friends, the thought of the two being together brings Lugosi's instincts back to the surface.
あの時、確かにしたんだ。ルイさんから覚えのある匂いが。息も絶え絶えで。切羽詰まって苦しいことばかり。今こんなにはっきりと分かってしまったんだ。俺は君が好きだ。
And you know what else makes Lugosi's blood boil? Haru getting kidnapped by an all-lion criminal organization. Look, I'm trying to emulate the brisk pace of this anime adaptation, so let's just get to the season finale. The criminals' leader, Chief Lion,Yeah, that's really what they call him, wants to eat Haru because she's supposed to be pure white, and that's the only kind of meat he really likes. The city mayor, also a lion, doesn't want to ruin his relationship with his species, so he resolves to do nothing. This leaves only Lugosi to rescue her, especially since Louis is unable to. Of course, Lugosi has some doubt whether he can save Haru, but all that worry washes away in the heat of the battle when he believes one of them hurt her, and in doing so, awakens to his primal rage.So eventually, with aid from a muscular panda named Gohan, who runs a clinic in the black market and helped him out with an issue he had, and Haru deciding to take Lugosi's feelings into consideration and not let herself be humiliated anymore, we eventually get the big battle between Lugosi and Chief Lion.Lugosi monologues about how his wolf strength is not something to be feared, that it can be used to protect the ones he loves. Final battles ensues, he wins, and he's able to escape with Haru. But not before Louis makes a surprise entrance to finish off the boss.
あんたは今から俺に命乞いしろ。お前ら肉食獣が恐怖に震える姿を俺に見せろ。泣きじゃくれ。さあ、許しを乞え。
救いなんてないんだ、この世には。暗闇へ溶けていこう。腐り切った大人たちと戦うのはもう終わりだ。名誉も誇りも全て失って楽になれ。
4番だ。商品番号4番。軟弱で体は小さいが味は保証するぜ。角以外何も残すな。感謝してくれよ。
Spoilers! He's obviously alive! You can't just kill off a main character like that! Lugosi and Haru won't make it back to the academy till morning, so they decide to stay at a love hotel. Since this is Beastars, I imagine they're designed to where the animals can make love.Like animals?
Nonsense. They're no different than ordinary hotels. The rooms are a bit fancier, that's all.
Well, damn. Our couple wants their money's worth, so they try to have sex. Much to Lugosi's embarrassment. I mean, species aside, the size difference must really make this awkward, even with Haru's deep well of sexual experience.But even Haru's internal instincts stop her from doing it with him. But that's okay. Lugosi thought they were moving a bit too fast anyway. The season slowly wraps up with life returning to normal, Louis's disappearance notwithstanding. Juno lights up Lugosi's conviction to face society head on, which in turn gives him the resolve to continue fighting to ensure he can be with Haru. It's a decent setup for things to come, but what really set things up for the next season...is the post-credit scene that follows.
やっと見つけた。みんな探してたよ。 早く行こう。ん？何笑ってるの？
Oh yeah, they never did figure out who the killer was. We sure got sidetracked there. But anyway, that's the first season of Beastars for you. It's an interesting love story that runs into world-building problems, but is dramatic and exciting enough to make up for them. I didn't get into these parts too much, but the voice acting in both Japanese and English is great, and the music helps ratchet up the atmosphere. Watching the anime made me more interested in the manga that it adapted, and I hope that my review made you interested in it too. There is more to it than just pretty anthros with a bit of action on the side. There are plenty of likable characters that I didn't get to mention along the way, but, you know, it's probably just something worth experiencing yourself. Whether you take the anime or the manga, I would definitely recommend at least one viewing or reading session. Hopefully, if another season comes by, I'll end up doing that one as well. And hopefully at a better pace. Next time, we look at a request for another Hanna-Barbera original film. I'll see you then.